究竟是什么人、什么事，竟能在这个节骨眼上，让美国总统川普、联邦准备理事会主席鲍威尔和民主党议员们罕见地站到了同一阵线，还口径一致起身踏伐？答案是全球社群网站巨擘 Facebook 创办人查克伯格，还有他开发的加密货币。不久前，川普在推文中发难，剑指该公司的虚拟加密货币 Libra 根本不是钱，谴责任何这类交易工具都需受到美国金融监管机构和银行相关法令规范，还强调在货币地位上唯有美元才是王道。鲍威尔接着对虚拟加密货币衍生的金融稳定、洗钱、消费者保护和逃漏税等风险公开表达疑虑。民主党总统参选人华伦则紧咬反垄断法，频频和查克伯格隔空交火。七月中 ，Facebook 加密货币出师不利，首度出席国会参众两院听证会就惨遭围剿。
Facebook has demonstrated through scandal after scandal that it doesn't deserve our trust. It should be treated like the profit-seeking corporation it is, just like any other company. Look at Facebook's record. We'd be crazy to give them a chance to experiment with people's bank accounts, to use powerful tools they don't understand, like monetary policy, to jeopardize hardworking Americans' ability to provide for their family. This is a recipe for more corporate power over markets and consumers, and fewer and fewer.Your protections for my constituents.
We really hope, and this is our ambition, that we can lower the barriers for access to modern financial services and massively lower costs for the people who need it the most.
拥有全球24亿人口社群基础的 Facebook 于六月中宣布了发行虚拟加密货币的计划，表示未来若要使用这项和比特币类似、以区块链技术为架构、和一篮子国际法定货币挂钩，但是生态体系更健全的全球性数位原生货币，只需用手机下载由 Facebook 自家研发的电子钱包 APP Calibra， 就可透过低成本且流动性高的交易支付平台，从现金交易经济跨越到数位经济的世界。该公司提到 ，Libra 协会已经成立，总部设于瑞士日内瓦，有近30家具社会公信力的公司允诺担任验证者节点，最终目标是100家。Facebook 还承诺不会把手伸进组织运作中，企业内部也会妥善分隔 Facebook 和 Calibra 两者使用者各自。但是这番说辞听在已经有预设立场的国会诸公耳里，简直是引火上身。
After people's data and private messages have been stolen and sold, after you've let Russian bots try to throw the 2016 election with no contrition, I might add, after you've abetted genocide in foreign countries, you really think people should trust you with their bank accounts in our economy? I just think that's delusional.
就在同一时间 ，Facebook 在2018年初向政治分析公司泄露8700万名用户个资、侵害隐私权一案上，与美国联邦贸易委员会达成和解，同意支付$50亿天价罚款，比先前 Google 于2012年支付的$2250万高出了220倍，创下美国政府对科技产业的开罚记录。讽刺的是 ，Facebook 股价不跌反升。当天上涨近2%，市值增加了$104亿，引发外界批评。若以 Facebook 今年获利展望为$691亿估算，这波制裁根本不痛不痒。而在国会山庄，不论该公司如何辩解发行加密货币的目的，并非和银行竞争，也不会支付利息，但是议员们仍然紧咬不放。
The trust deficit is incredible to really see. You know, there were some senators who just blatantly said, we don't trust you. Why should we ever trust you with a new currency? You know, why don't you fix your other problems before you start creating new ones? It just kind of sets this standard or this idea that no matter what Facebook does, they've lost so much trust at the moment that it's hard to imagine that this is going to take off in the way that they want it to.
项以古罗马帝国称重单位命名的虚拟加密货币 Libra 预计在2020年上路，但是媒体日前报道，七大工业国集团已经表态暂不打算放行 Libra 在境内流通，或基于资讯安全，或基于对现有货币体系造成威胁而准备干预，禁止民营企业跨越发行国币，挑战央行主权的红线。而外交政策期刊三年前一篇没有引起太多关注，揭发前利比亚狂人格达费是因为企图发行金本位货币与欧元和美元抗衡，才会引发北约军事介入灭口的爆炸性调查报道，又回头让 Libra 弥漫鬼影幢幢。当地时间10月13日， Libra 协会召开首次理事会议前夕，媒体爆出有参议员致函多家机构，威胁若参与新货币计划将会受到监管机关严密检视。隔天果然有重量级信用卡发行公司和支付机构等重要成员突然打了退堂鼓，宣布撤出协会和 Facebook 进行切割。
What's your take on all of these companies abandoning Facebook? How much more of a hurdle is this now for Facebook?
I think it's insurmountable, but without the banking system behind them, I mean, without the payments processors behind them, I don't think they can pull it off. I mean, I don't think they're capable of building out that infrastructure themselves. If it's not accepted at places where Visa and MasterCard are accepted, it's just not going to work. So, you know, short of a big bank stepping into JP Morgan and saying, we're all in and we're going to support this no matter what, I don't think this can ever happen.
彭博分析认为 Facebook 这几年名声信誉早已有损，接下来的闯关任务将十分艰巨，而公关费用势必也会和获利一样继续节节高升。